they're all locked, so you can go wait for it. And then Mom and John, both of you, when you come in, just be really quiet and no clapping in between the pieces. Downstairs, you can sit with your mom. Okay.
Good afternoon, and welcome to this virtual recital. My name's Daniel Wicks, and I'm a 10th grade organ student here at First Lutheran Church in Colorado Springs. That first piece was Gymnopédie No. 1 by the French composer Erik Satie. It's the first piece in a set of three published in 1888. The title there, Gymnopédie, is rather unusual, and no one's quite sure what Satie meant by that, but the word Gymnopédie comes from the Greek word Gymnopédia, which was an ancient Spartan festival. And what that has to do with that piece is anybody's guess, but it was published with an excerpt from the poem Les Antiques by Latour, where the term appears. It goes in strangely evocative language, slanting and shadow cutting a bursting stream, trickled in gusts of gold on the shiny flagstone, where the amber atoms in the fire gleaming mingled their sarabande with the Gymnopédia. This piece has been popular ever since its composition, and as a little bit of proof that it will remain so, at least for another 200 years, to the 23rd century, in the Star Trek Next Generation episode, First Contact, Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Enterprise was listening to it in his office. So this next piece is, Ach bleib mit deiner Gnade by the German composer Siegfried Kargelert. He was a German pianist and organist in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. And this piece is from his 66 chorale improvisations, which was his first original work for organ. This piece is very much like a Bach work and may have been written with the style of Bach in mind.
Thank you.
Isn't that a lovely little piece? So now, on to something a little more exciting. We have Dietrich Buxtehude's A Mighty Fortress Is Our God. Now, Buxtehude was a Danish organist and composer of the Baroque period. He was very influential. His style inspired many people, including his student, the young Johann Sebastian Bach. In fact, he was so popular that Bach walked 200 miles to hear him play in Lübeck in 1705. He only left when Buxtehude wanted him to marry his daughter, who is not at all attractive. This piece is an ornamented chorale prelude with the melody in the top part. It might not be in everyone's hymnals, so this is the first part of the tune. So your challenge is to see if you can hear that in here. Thank you. Now I'm going to play sort of a set by the blind French composer Jean Langlais. Now, Langlais was blind because of glaucoma, which he had at age 2. He studied organ with André Marchal, who is also blind, at the National Institute for Blind Children in Paris. Later, he studied at the Paris Conservatoire, studying with Marcel Dupré and Paul Dukas. He followed in the footsteps of César Franck as the organist at Saint-Clotilde in Paris. And here's a bit of a quote. It's a little lengthy, but I liked it. It's about his music. As Langlais' music is written in a highly individual, eclectic style, venturing well beyond what might be expected of a mid-20th century French composer, with rich and complex harmonies and overlapping modes, sometimes more tonal than his contemporary Olivier Messiaen, sometimes related to his two predecessors at Saint-Clotilde, Franck and Tournemire, but sometimes also employing serial techniques and often exhibiting an earthy Celtic folkiness, which owes not a little to Bartok. So the first piece here is the Tiento, which is from his Suite Medievale, which was a low mass or messe basse composed in 1947. Used the medieval Gregorian themes of the Catholic Mass. And this movement, the offertoire, or the offertory, uses the Kyrie. Now, in case you're curious, a tiento is a Spanish form of keyboard music, which originated sometime in the mid-15th century. It's analogous to the English or German fantasia. Now, it's usually some kind of fugue or rondo, and this one, true to form, does have a repeating theme, and it enters many times, so I want you to see how many times you hear it come in through the piece. So there's that, and then this is the Kyrie, or the beginning of it at least. And the second piece will be the Prière, or Prayer, which is the movement 15 in the 24, or 24, pieces for harmonium or organ. This is Opus 6 of 1936. It's a small piece, exquisitely beautiful. Thank you. Well, now we're getting close to the end of the program, so I just want to thank all of you for joining me today for this virtual recital. And now, to conclude, I would like to play the Suite Liturgique by Canadian composer Denis Bédard. Now, this suite is also, like the Suite Médiévale, for a low mass. It has movements for all the major musical moments in the service. It has the prelude, or the entrée, as it's called in here, the offering, or offertoire, communion, or as translated to plain English, communion, and the postlude, or voluntary, or as it's called in there, the sortie. As an aside, Bédard also founded the company that publishes his music, Editions Chaldar. So thank you so much for listening, and enjoy the Suite Liturgique.